Alright, a little more science here on the cypress. And because they're so tall, right next to the ocean, they have many things. They have many things they're doing extra, including salt filtering. They do filter the salt a little bit. I didn't actually want to get into that right now. I wanted to more to talk about wind, the wind effect, and what they've been doing all these years. Now, the older they get, you know, you plant a young tree next to the ocean, it's just like, ah, what's happened? What's happened for so many years? Okay, and then when it gets older, it's matured. So when that tree has gotten older and it's matured, it's smoothed. It's smoothed over, hasn't it? It's smoothed over by the many, many years of the wind, of the way the climate has gone. I mean, centuries. Just this is the way it goes. It goes over this way, this tree to that tree. And so you'll have the wind go zunk, 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 for years and years and years. Hundreds. And so now we take those away. So instead of the Tai Chi factor where it was going yao yao, just billowing in and through, smoothing over the tops and through the branches, instead of that, you're going to have, whoa, there was no stop. You see, there will be no stop. Aside from the hill itself, there will be no stop. When it hits that hill, it's going to create a twist. It's going to bounce out, and it's going to start creating one of those out. Okay, so it's going to create storms that right here, just right here, because it's not able to do its Tai Chi effect that it was doing. Okay. Now, I didn't really study the salt deal so much with the filtration going through the clearing out of the oceans through salts, because salt, we know salts are very damaging to the to human and animal life. Yeah, I can't talk right now. I'm speaking, all right. We know salts are very damaging. You can't drink them at sea. They cause insanity. You know, all kinds of things like that go on with too much salt. So sea salt is very dangerous. However, we've had these trees. You see, we've had these trees. They so drang, drang, drang. Here comes the salt. The salt breezes. The salt sprays. The salt clouds. A lot of heavy salt in those clouds. And they've just kind of well dropped, fogged on to these cypress trees, to these Monterey pines specifically. They've hung around there. Okay. So they've lost a lot of that heavy right here in this area. It's very, very salted grounds. Okay, so they've lost a lot here. And now because those trees will be missing, you know, take them away, it's like, well, I gotta have to carry that salt a little further, and a little further, and a little further. So we'll have a little bit more salt accumulation heading inland. Okay. All right. Next, what else do I want? I wanted to also talk about just, okay, we know that the age factor, when it is that really young and stupid, it's essentially a young and stupid tree, and it's learning just like you in life. It's like, what the heck is going on? That wind hurt, you know, and it moves a little bit more this way. Yeah, they do that. They adjust. They adjust to certain characters of life. They adjust. They rearrange themselves. They move. They bend their you see them all the time. They bend the angles. They change their angles. It's not just the roots. It's not how it's planted. and how they grew, it's literally, they're readjusting because of the winds also. So that's life learned. It's a life learned event. Now, interestingly, the trees around here, for the most part, are very straight. They're very straight trees. So they've been in a continuum of circumstance where they were not in egregious weather. They have not actually experienced that. They've been more just living in a bonsai world with Tai Chi all around them. But now, you know, as more and more have been removed, the Sharps Park has had a whole bunch hauled off. As more and more, because you can go right to the park now and you can look, sit on one side and see the houses on the other. And that was never done before. You could never do that before. Now you can see houses from side to side. So they've really had a tantrum effect with their machines. So yeah, so those trees now, where they were straight before, and they were involved in the ability to almost control. We will say it almost control heavy storm effect. They're not going to be able to. Any newer trees are going to be more bent. They are going to grow on angles. They're going to be hit heavier. It's a pretty bad damage to new tree life also. So what does an old tree know? You know, when after 1,000 years, what does an old tree know? What has it learned? Well, right now, it's been shaped, it's been formed by the years and years of climate. So we can say, you know, 70-75% of us, you know, which are trees, we are 75% a tree as humans. We can say that, well, you know, what did I learn? What did I learn in those 1,000 years? You know, I must have learned something. Because each time, you know, the tree wakes up in the morning, you know, there's an attraction effect. There's an attraction effect with the cloud. The cloud is attracted to that tree. Absolutely calls it. Now, without the tree, where does the cloud go? I'm wondering. Without the tree, where does the cloud go? It's not really interested anymore, as it was. Before, it had a building place. It had almost a lover aspect. You know, that cloud goes and settles there. It gets transpiration, rebuilds, days and nights. It's like it gets a boost. It's not going to get that. So the cloud itself now is cheated. Each cloud that comes rolling in is a cheated cloud. It's not getting the boost. It's not getting that rebuild. So what that means is less rain, less precipitation brought in towards Sacramento. Less precipitation means less rain. Okay, less rain. So, did I make that point clear that the cloud itself now will not be such a big deal? You won't have such monster clouds, monster fogs. Oh my gosh, San Francisco used to have monster fogs in the mornings. Like huge, it was just incredible. It would just roll in over the bay all the way past Yerba Buena. Monster fogs when I grew up. Anyway, so yeah, I believe the monster fogs are going to be going away. They're not going to have that that pleasure laxidation any longer. It's just going to be water to water. It's just going to be cloud to water effect. That's all the cloud, the fog is going to get anymore. When the trees aren't there, you're not going to have any kind of extra in the middle. There's just not going to be more of a boost. It's not going to have a boost factor. So that's where I'm headed with my clouds going away theory. All right, but that doesn't stop the wind. The wind is amazing. It can be in, you never need a cloud for wind. Never. That sucker will just go and go and go. So you guys will get that. And, gosh darn it. I'm like, well, what else? What else? I wanted to talk about the tendrils of the cypress, the actual nettles of themselves, the old age evergreen matter. That evergreen matter is extremely interesting versus the new evergreen matter. The new evergreen matter, I'm sure you've all seen it, it's very vibrant, it's bright, it's like, ooh, look, you know, brand new, looks also nutritious, and it looks really strong and healthy and thick. But when it's older, it has changed, hasn't it? It has been molded, it has been sculpted, it's moved, it's changed, it's rearranged itself. It's done all of these actions, whereas the new one has not done any of that. It learns by effect. The tree learns by effect as it grows older. You know, you go that way too far, it hurts. You go this way too far, it's just right. Okay, so here's 1,000 years old. It's like, well, maybe not so beautiful anymore. Maybe people don't like me. But 1,000 years old has learned by effect. He's learned by effect, that tree, that, or her, him or her, because they have males and females. Yeah, they've learned by effect. So yeah, that's, anyway, I don't know, it seems like there's a million tree lessons I have to give, but I can't give it all right now. Anyway, I was pretty heavy the last few days. I was talking about murder and their rights for it. I have killed before. I have killed, not a human being, but I have killed roosters. And it was a terrible experience, but I had to do it. So when those times happen, it was for survival. It was for survival of another rooster. I had to kill the roosters to kill another rooster, I mean, to save another rooster. That's just the way it goes. In a small environment, those types of things had to happen. So yeah, murder is a bit of a weirdo, isn't it? Because we really are a small environment. And so those things obviously are happening all over this Bay Area. They're happening all over all these populated cities. You know, when the roosters were trying to kill my rooster, I had to kill them, you see. And so you end up with those types of situations. Very simple, but in on a man-to-man basis, a woman-to-woman basis, etc. And so there you go, you know, finding reasons for murder in a very, very short bit of space here in these populated cities. Yeah. Anyway, I was an awful thing. I you know, it was a terrible thing to kill them. And I don't know what to do. When they attack and they attack and they attack and try to kill, they're bad. They're just bad. There are bad roosters out there. And I had to kill them. But anyway, very difficult because I had to catch them and then choke them. But You don't want to know all those details, I'm sure, but it's very exciting. You know, farm life is very exciting sometimes. And I believe they're buried there back at the farm in the back garden somewhere if you want to go dig them up. Find two rooster bones side by side. But yeah, that's about it for me on the murder scale. Aside from a few flies today. Anyway, as man just feels it's okay to murder trees willy-nilly, I call that murder also. I'm not an advocate of murdering trees, okay? I think it's a crime. So, there we go. Anyway, did I make it clear? Okay, so you'll be more insane heading in towards the off the ocean ways because you'll have more salt. You'll have less clouds, less rain, and there'll be more wind. Okay. And all of the learning of that tree, all those years instead, it's going to be now any tree that grows is now really going to be, what do you call it when they're on angles, they're going to grow in bad situations now. You take their health away. You take their health away and you expose them to severe danger. You take their health away. Not the old trees now, I'm talking about the brand new trees, any new trees that are planted. Their health will be taken away by the wind factor. And drought will now be higher because of the less clouds. Okay, what else? Dun, 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 dun. I got that. What do you call that? Oh, gosh. No, that's it. I think that's it. That's all I have right now. The ravens. This is that invisible cord they use, that I'm using. The ravens are fighting. They're fighting over the trees remaining. I saw them today doing hawk fighting out there. So, yeah, it's getting a little tense with the birds. And the one I put up there, I put that image up there, I can't confirm that was the black silky one. The black silky one I saw was closer to me. That was the one that I could take a photo of, and it really looked like him from a distance, but I can't really confirm that's exactly him. So, darn it, the one I saw was almost looked a little different, but... I don't know. I don't have one of those fast up lenses. What else? What else is going to change? Well, I imagine with all of this, they get an easier road through. If you didn't watch my last video, they'll get an easier road to the other side of the mountain, if that hasn't already been slated. And then I imagine they can just put in, I don't know, what about 100 houses, 50 to 100 houses on that hill, and not a forest. Yeah, they wouldn't, why would they replant a forest, you know, why would they do anything, you know, that made any sense? Why would they do anything that made sense? Oh, I hate ending with the discussion of man and its inordinate want for a house, so I won't. I'll just go back to the world of the giant bonsais here and their Tai Chi effect they've had for over 1,000 years in this region of California.